right, let's look some more. Now, go back to Isaiah. Let's go to millennium again and pick some things and see what happens again in the millennium and what we should expect in our lives. So when people don't know this, they just live their life from day to day struggling. No, 1,000 times no. 1,000 times no. I want to show you how to live the Christian life. Understand it. All right. So, Isaiah chapter 60, we go to verse 8. Verse 8. Who are these that fly as a cloud and as a dove to their windows? Surely the eyes shall wait for me and the ships of Tarshish. First to bring thy sons from far, their silver and their gold with them, unto the name of the Lord thy God, and to the Holy One of Israel, because he hath glorified thee. Did you see that? Now, because he has glorified thee. Look at verse 6. And for stones iron, I will also make thy officers peace, and thine exactors righteousness. Prosperity everywhere. At the millennium, they're going to be so prosperous. But, you know, too many Christians have taken the word of God too lightly. They read them, they didn't understand what the Lord was saying. Let me show you what the Bible says. First, I want to look at the teachings of Jesus. In St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 12, from verse 22, let's read what he said. And he said unto his disciples, therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat, neither for the body, what ye shall put on. The life is more than meat, and the body is more than raiment. Consider the ravens, for they neither sow nor reap, which neither have storehouse nor barn, and God feedeth them. How much more are ye better than the fowls? Wow. Go on. And which of you with taking thought can add to his stature one cubit? By your thinking and worrying, can you add one little inch to your height? By your worrying? If ye then be not able to do that thing which is least, why take ye thought for the rest? Says, why do you care? Next verse. Consider the lilies, how they grow. They toil not. I want you to listen to what Jesus is telling you. I want you to listen to what Jesus is telling you. His words are so important. He says, consider the lilies, how they grow. They toil not. They spin not. And yet I say unto you that Solomon, that's King Solomon, in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. Next verse. If then God so clothed the grass, which is today in the field and tomorrow is cast into the oven, how much more will he clothe you, O ye of little faith? Ah. And seek not ye what he shall eat or what he shall drink, neither be ye of doubtful mind. Says, don't be of doubtful mind. For all these things do the nations of the world seek after, and your Father knoweth that you have need of these things. He says, your Father knows that you have need of these things. Oh, God. Next verse. But rather seek ye the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added unto you. He says, don't seek them. Don't worry about them. Don't worry about your life. He says, they toil not, neither do they spin. Yet Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed as one of them. Wow. Next verse. Fear not, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. And then he did.
Yes, sir.
This was before he gave them the kingdom. And then he did. He gave it to them. That's how we got it. So what's he telling you? He says your prosperity is not because of your job. It's not because of your business. Whatever job you do, whatever business you do, do them well to contribute to your society. It is important, but that's not where your prosperity comes from. Your prosperity comes because you belong in the kingdom of God. You're a child of God. Think about it. You're called to inherit a blessing. Don't say, where is it going to come from? Oh, he says, be ye not of doubtful mind. Don't be of doubtful mind. This is Papa's word, so bless it. Any work you can do to be a contributor to the development of our world, do it, because it's Papa's word. Take care of it. But one thing is certain, as you serve him that way, nothing is too good for you. Nothing is too good for you. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. No wonder. Look at Philippians chapter 4, verse 19. No wonder. No wonder. Look at it. But my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. My God shall supply all your need according to his riches, not according to your need. I want you to understand, he supplies your need according to his riches. In other words, if you have a need of one house, he don't mind giving you 10. Can you see it? You need a house? Papa says, I got a lot of them. I give you according to my riches. He gives you more than you require. Masata Rabakuti. Oh, glory to God. According to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. That's why I will always walk in prosperity. I will always live in prosperity. Manto Cobra Digilehes. Look at 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 8. You say, how does it work? I want to show it to you. Here's how it works. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse number 8. And God is able, say, able. God is able to make all grace abound towards you. In other words, he's able to direct his grace towards you. Channel his grace in your direction. God is able to make all grace abound towards you, that he always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. Oh, God. Maybe I should read it to you from the Amplified Translation. Look at it from the Amplified Translation. And God is able to make all grace, every favor and earthly blessing come to you in abundance, I told you, so that you may always and under all circumstances and whatever the need be self-sufficient, possessing enough to require no aid or support, and furnished in abundance for every good work and charitable donation. Shout amen, somebody. Yeah. Woo, hallelujah. Oh, God. We're talking life of the saints. Did you notice what Paul said? He said, but my God shall supply all your need. He said, I have learned in whatever state I am to be independent of circumstances. Yes. Independent of circumstances, because we are above the world and its systems. Thanks be unto God. Don't be of doubtful mind. Set your mind on the word. All right. So, that's beautiful. Prosperity is ours in the now. They're gonna have to wait for the millennium to experience extraordinary prosperity. You know, we talk about Israel even today. There are lots of wealthy individuals, but in Israel, you still have a lot of needy people. In fact, there's a lot of need. The people who are sending relief to Israel up till now, relief to Israel. Because the many who came back poor, very poor, and they are there. But at the millennium, there will be not one poor person among them. Amen. But in Christ, there's no poor among us. So What happened then to some people? Because they know not, neither will they understand. So they walk on in darkness. But I have said, ye are gods, and all of ye are children of the Most High. Because they ignored the word. Hallelujah.